and welcome back. This is Frost here, and we are playing MLB The Show. Bit the loss yesterday against Philly, late in the game. But we're back at it again today. It is Monday the 5th, so we are 3 days ahead. Let's hopefully we can get this going here. Let's see if we can't cram two games in today. Paul Skeens, our first day with him. Let's get Lourdes out here. Let's get Schwarber in. Who else do we want to see? Perdomo. Let's get Drury in. And then let's see. He can't play shortstop. Cattell can. And then let's do that and put Let's try this lineup, see how it goes. See how it goes.
Welcome into Chase Field in downtown Phoenix. Major League Baseball on tap. It's the Philadelphia Phillies and the Arizona Diamondbacks. First pitch coming your way next.
Let's do it.
This is Bryson Stott.
There's no way this is my first outing with him, right?
In the air, out towards right center. McCarthy makes the grab on the run. Brandon Marsh.
No, because I think I've seen before he only throws 98. So this guy is second outing with him.
On the outside corner, 1-2. One out, base is empty. Yeah, the 1-2 misses to even the count.
I think I might need to update his stats to have him throw faster.
Swings through that one. It's a strikeout.
My man's hitting triple pitches regularly.
It started. Three-pitch strikeout. You've got to be better at the plate right there. At least to foul something off, extend that at bat.
Popped up left side. And that'll do it.
Fuck, I should put Wisdom at third and Castellanos at DH.
And now, Corbin Carroll. That one way inside.
No, that's fine. So I'm more likely to pitch it for Wisdom than I am to pitch it for Castellanos. It's Castellanos is a better hitter.
Field. Marsh makes the grab, and there's one down. An outstanding hitter in Cattell Marte. One down, base is empty. Sliced hard but foul.
Hard but foul.
Swing and a high fly ball.
Yeah,
out there
popping everything up,
field.
Man.
He makes the catch, and there's two down.
I love
two
it.
Two outs, base is empty. Now up next for Arizona, Kyle
He's
Schwarber.
That thrower down, too.
Pop. Fuck. Boom. Under it. And that is that. And the Diamond.
It's three pop-ups.
Back here in the desert, all set for the start of the inning. And now it's the cleanup spot for the Phillies. Trey Turner, next offered in there for a strike. And the count, 1-2. Almost got him. Straighten him up a little
bit. Yeah, suck on that fastball, bitch.
That one just misses the outside corner. Full count now.
I'm with you, boo.
Line drive, speared at first. Alonso steps on the bat. One up, one down. Here's Jock Peterson.
Jock's killing it in real life right now.
Glover to right field.
Just like that.
Back, gone. A gigantic blast.
I mean, Arizona seemed
second homer of the year, and they grab the lead. It's 1-0.
Arizona's seen an abnormal number of left-handed pitchers this year. So he's not batting against lefties, really. And he still has 17 home runs, which is good.
That's hard hit on the line. Drops for a hit. He couldn't run it down.
Oh, Visions of Mana demo. I'm going to buy Visions of Mana regardless, probably. Because I have all the other ones, I think, just not on the Xbox.
Now it's going to be Johan Rojas.
So it's like, you know,
soft contact in the air. That's a base hit. Lead runner around second. The throw to third. He's in there. What a way. Runners at first and third. Rodolfo Castro. Now
more issues, man.
He might want to steal second in this spot, but he's dealing with a catcher that has one of the best pop times in the game. He needs to pick his spot very wisely.
At the belt and fires. Got him swinging. Two gone now. And now, Garrett Stubbs.
Two balls, one strike.
This one in the dirt. Runners stay put, and the count moves to 2-1. And the righty deals. Wouldn't chase that time. Chris, with that distraction and a speedy guy at first, he's in a favorable hitter's count.
Well, if nothing else, I mean, this is a great spot for a hitter to be in. Pretty easy walk right there. Last pitch wasn't even much to think about.
And next is the designated hitter, Bryson Stott. Traffic on the bases with one already in here at the top of the second. Next pitch way upstairs. Got him. Inning over, and it could have been worse. But they're off to a good start as they pick up a run on this solo shot. And the home team down a run. You're watching Major League Baseball exclusively on the show. Breaking down the young and what I owe them. Trying to fit into an aura that I'm molding. And welcome back to the ballpark. Nick Castellanos at the plate now. Hit hard. Should be extra bases.
All right. There we go.
Now he'll turn for second.
Gives a nice little leadoff double.
Couldn't have timed it up any better than that. Just a great approach. Looked like that was exactly what he wanted to do with that pitch. And right off the bat, he knew he was taking that wide turn at first to head for second.
Patrick Wisdom stands in now for the Diamondbacks.
Outside, baby.
Swing and a miss. And the count one and two.
Well, the best way to shake off yesterday's struggles is to get on the board early. They've got a guy in scoring position. They've got to find a way here to get him in.
And it's even up.
Hitter's got some good.
I almost swung at that shit.
What I like about something being hit to the right side into the outfield is that the base runner at second has a very good read and can determine whether or not he can score on that base hit.
Swings through that, and
he
it's a strikeout.
Throwing
not
good
what
stuff.
You're looking for after the leadoff double. A strikeout, and there's one away. Brandon Drury to the plate. Swing and a drive, deep right field. That one back there. Back. Gone.
There you go, Brandon.
He leaves the yard to right, and they throw a pair on the board. It's 2-1.
He's been so difficult to pitch against lately. It seems like no matter how you attack him, he finds a way to punish you.
And another ball. Swing and a miss.
Oh.
Threw that fastball right by him, slightly elevated. That's a confidence boost for this guy out there on the mound. See if he continues to climb the ladder.
Still only one out here in the inning. Out to short, Turner. The throw to first, and that takes care of Alonzo. Next up for the Diamondbacks, Bobby
finished downloading. Might be a game to play pretty soon.
Foul ball. Gets a piece there. We'll do it again. Base is empty. Two away, but two runs are in at bottom half of inning number two.
Outside.
And nope, that's outside. Two and two.
Let's look at that. I got very tired all of a sudden. I don't know what it is.
In the air to left center. Marsh running hard.
Alright, that's
a nice running catch. And that ends the inning. D-backs add a pair on the homer. And this is now a 2-1 ball game. You're watching Arizona Diamondbacks baseball on the show Southwest. Making noise in the big toys. Celebrate out the on to the third inning. Now the number two hitter, Brandon Marsh. This kid picked up in a trade. A lot was offered and given to get him, but he's got a real high ceiling.
Well, after putting up a nice inning on offense, got some runs across, this is where you look for the starter to go out there, have a shutdown inning. Don't give that other team any hope.
Give him a ball.
Back up there while they're hot.
Next offering in there for a strike. And the count is 2-2. And a swing and a miss. Leadoff man retired here in the third.
Honestly, fastball changeup.
One down, Phillies down a
combo,
run.
Man.
That's ripped to right down the line. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And there are two outs. Here's Turner now. Here's a 1-1. And that skips into there. The Christer of the early
stages. Honestly, should have put out the Schwarber at
efficient in terms of the pitch count. He's gonna
DH. Put Wisdom at third, put Castellanos in right field. That would have been the smart idea.
The catch,
but I'm not being smart today.
And yeah. We're back. Set for the bottom of the third. Now here is Gabriel Moreno.
Oh my God. I was yawning.
Ripped to short, snagged on a bounce.
I just can't like, consider things whether they're high or low or not. I have a really, really hard time figuring it out.
Wouldn't chase that time. Right through there for a strike.
Careful.
The pitch. And he walked him.
Boo, do you think you could draw a walk in the bigs if we gave you enough at bats?
Boo, that's a good question. I think that if they gave the pitcher a false scouting report on me, yes, I think I could draw a walk. Harper. He handles it himself. No chance at the double play with the runner in motion. Kyle Schwarber comes up to hit here. Runner at second, two down. Here in the last half of the third. Now a pop-up on the infield. Harper has a beat on it. Makes the grab, and that'll end the inning. So it's no... Back here at Chase Field as we go to the top of the fourth. And Jack Peterson stands in. Comes up empty. That's strike two.
One ball, two strikes.
That misses the zone. Two and two.
His slider like bend down too. That's really interesting.
Righty delivers. Swings through it, and that's a strikeout. And now it's Alec Bohm. In the air to left down the line. Brings it in. Two down.
Ooh.
Johan Rojas.
The game's zooming by. Why am I so tired?
To get the call. And the count is 3-1.
I mean, I went to sleep at a relatively like early time last night.
That one hit to right.
Been tired.
Schwarber settles under it. He's got it, and that'll end the inning. Bottom of the fourth. Here's Nicholas Castellanos. That's way outside, and it's 2-1.
You know, these D-backs doing a great job, Boog, of just waiting for the right pitch to come their way. And I'm seeing very patient at-bats out of them. They're doing a good job of working the pitch count, and they've been able to push a couple of runs across to score as well.
Man, he smoked that fastball. He's all over it. It's just frustrating when you can't get it to fall. Maybe next time off, he'll find a hole.
So next is the designated hitter for the D-backs, Patrick Wisdom. Base is empty, one away here in the second game of the series.
Still relatively early, but with a pair of runs already on the board, the ripple effect of that high pitch count might set him up to do more damage later in this game.
Kicks and deals. Fouls it off, still 1-2.
Your itches.
Righty to the plate.
The ball.
Two balls, two strikes.
Nope, not down the middle.
Just missing there. And it's 3-2.
Well, I think he's trying to get a feel for where that one missed. I mean, it could have gone either way, but he looked a little shocked for a second there.
Inside ball four.
You know, I think he's okay with that outcome. It wasn't an intentional walk, but he wasn't exactly trying to attack the zone either.
And a pitch. Swing and a miss.
He's pitching well, but not throwing a ton of first pitch strikes. Usually doesn't work out for success, but you can never predict baseball.
My thumb fell off the thing. I bet you it. Like the middle of the, oh no, it was there. It was just late. Huh.
And another ball. Two outs. Ripped to third.
Oh.
And that'll end the.
Ready
now for the fifth inning, and now it's the switch hitting second baseman Rodolfo Castro. Next offering is in.
About even on pitch count, I think, because he was at 71. He'll be at 71 in the bottom half. I started 72.
Stays alive.
That's with my pitch count, like with my the beginning of this at bat. So that's good.
Just misses with that one.
It's a good take.
Yeah, the fans are not happy with that umpire.
On the ground, right side. Toss to Alonso, and the leadoff man set down, and they're
heading to Gabby was 1-for-18.
And
wow.
For the Phillies, Garrett Stubbs. This one in the air. Marte should have it. Hauls it in for the out. Out number two. So the lineup flips over. Now it's the DH, Bryson Stott. Hard grounder into the outfield for a knock. And that keeps the inning going.
He needed that one. It's been a tough stretch at the plate lately. Pretty tough for the infielders to do anything with that one. He pulled it hard into the outfield. And even when you keep it on the ground, it feels great when you hit a missile like that. And now a chance to maybe get creative on offense with good speed on first.
Misses. Full count now.
I love this part of the game. Does he really want to try and steal second against this catcher? I know he's fast.
Oh, come on. That's a strike, man.
What he wanted to do there, Boo. That keeps this inning alive and gives this offense a good chance to cut into their deficit.
High in the air, out to right. And that's the third out. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. And here is Jake McCarthy. And a pitch. Foul ball there. The 1-2. Swing and a miss. And he struck him.
I knew that was where it was going to be. I just decided too late that I wanted to switch
it. Gabriel Moreno. One down, base is empty. up the middle. Trey Turner gloves it on the run, sends it over to target. He got him.
Fuck you, Trey Turner.
Well, it looks routine, but it hasn't been so easy for this club defensively this year. And you got to make those routine plays behind the pitcher. Helps him to get more comfortable and move through this ballgame.
Slapped foul. And the right-hander deals. Bouncer to second. Bare hand grab. Pretty nice play there.
Had to get him with the bare hand, too.
Nothing doing for Arizona, but they still lead it 2-1. Back here in the desert. All right, we go to the top half of inning number 6. So digging in now for Philadelphia, Trey Turner.
Love the fact that I'm not getting
good, you know, this
guy's great swings right now, but it could be the pitcher. It could be me being tired and just not recognizing pitches, like not being in the zone, you know.
And another ball. Line drive. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out.
Perfect.
And there's one down. And now Jack Peterson. Drilled to right. Way back there. And that is gone.
That wasn't where I wanted to throw it, Brad. That wasn't where I wanted to throw it.
Another homer.
I knew it. I knew that was going to happen.
It's 2-2.
He's mad we traded him.
Sounded different.
And might have been the loudest moment yet. Man, my ears are ringing. I can feel that swing from the booth.
Makes the grab. 2 down.
It's never fun going back to the dugout after hitting a line drive that finds a glove, but you will get some high fives. You know, when you make great contact, you feel like you've done everything right. But in this game of baseball, not everything is in your control.
Ripped, but it curls foul. Swing and a miss.
Got him. Let's go.
One scores in the inning coming on this.
Jock. Juckity.
Here's Ketel Marte. Kicks and fires. Hard hit, left field, base hit. So a runner aboard to start the inning.
Seems like he got
exactly what he was looking for right there. Nice job of driving that pitch the other way on a line. You know, hitters, they take so many reps in the cages working on going to the opposite field, and it doesn't always translate into the game, but right there it did, and he did it perfectly.
Some stirring in the bullpen for the Phillies. Wade Miley, the veteran southpaw, is getting ready to come on if needed. Sanchez getting loose as well. Left-hand batter waits. And a ball evens the count.
Man, oh man, I don't know how you take that pitch. That's as close as it gets.
There we go. Just gotta stay on it, man. I thought my guy was running.
With the controller down. That's one of those swings where you just don't even feel the ball hit the barrel. That's a pure stroke. A chance now to take the lead, and at this point in the game, that could be a deciding run.
That's off the mark, and it's 2-1.
Tough spot right here, a couple runners on, 2-ball count. You can't nibble, but you have to execute and finish your pitch. If you leave something out over the plate, it's going to bring in some runs.
And here it comes. Swings through that one for strike two.
He normally does damage on that pitch in that location. Just a swing and a miss there. Don't think you want to throw it again, though.
That one is absolutely belted. Should be extra bases. Runner around third on his way to the plate. One runs in.
I'll stay at third. You're slow.
But now he hits the brakes and hustles back to third.
Well, that was an important at bat in this game, so great job there stepping up to the challenge.
His second double.
They go with one of their more experienced arms in this spot, Wade Miley.
He doesn't get a lot of strikeouts compared to other relievers, so he relies on getting that soft contact and the defense doing work behind him. They'll have to be on their toes with him on the ball.
Got him swinging.
Oh, the slider. Damn, Patrick Wisdom sucks.
Man, that slider bearing in on your hands like that, it's just so tough to fight off. It's kind of like a cutter. It just can eat you up, saw you off. Tell you what, hitters have nightmares about that pitch. Perfectly executed
Dude,
out there.
Dude, all of his shit is like slow.
Second and third here. One away.
That's still early.
The pitch. Fouls it back with two strikes.
Everything's going to be like that. Okay.
Now a high fly ball out to left center. Rojas sizes this one up. He's got it. Both runners tagging from second and third. It's a sack fly as he comes across to score. It's 4-2.
Well, those can be pretty fun as an outfielder. Got to put it into his highest gear and go a long way to track that one down. Nothing better than that. You feel like a wide receiver playing football.
You're going to walk, Pete?
First and third, okay. Two away. Now a chance for Jake McCarthy. Popped up.
I disagree. That's a pop-up.
Makes the catch. And that is the inning. But two runs for him, and they jump ahead. Seventh inning coming up. It's the Diamondbacks 4 and the Phillies 2. Top of inning number 7. Now, Rodolfo Castro.
After scoring runs, this is where you're looking for that shutdown inning. Get that hot team back in there to swing the bats.
Let's see here.
The 1-2.
Got him.
Strikeout number 7. A big first out here in the 7th via the punch-out.
Yeah, it just does so much to change the outlook of an important inning like this. When you got the leadoff hitter,
Scott Barlow gets the ball now.
And he's had his struggles so far this year, as you can see the inflated ERA. Looking to bring that down a little bit right here.
And a pitch. That's a strike. It's 2-2.
Well, that's really the money spot. Down and away, if you can locate that consistently, it's going to be real tough for hitters to score that. That's what you'd love to see relievers do coming out of that bullpen.
Next is the designated hitter, Bryson Stott. Two down, nobody on. Here in the top half of inning number 7. Called strike 3 on the fastball, and that ran back over the inner half. Bottom of the inning, and now the catcher comes up to hit. Gabriel Moreno. Ball to strike. And that one fouled off.
You're on it. It was early. I forgot who was pitching.
That's the third. gathers and throws to first. And they get the leadoff hitter in the seventh. Next to hit for Arizona, Corbin Carroll.
Yes, so.
On the ground, right side. Whips it to first. Two up, two down.
Well, he didn't recognize changeup earlier enough. Got out in front a little bit, rolled over on it, and beat it into the ground. Been a solid inning so far in relief. Getting them through this inning only down two could give their lineup a real opportunity to just grind their way back into this game with the few outs that they have left.
And that gets down for a base hit.
I get smoked the bullpen. I totally forgot about it.
Schwarber.
That's back-to-back singles for him. Nice line drive to the pole side right there, but he didn't spin off of it. That's the key. You still
let's
have
get
to extend
Lourdes
to the
there.
Baseball in order to hit a
Lourdes
line drive.
Bat. And then also, let's get her up.
Step off throw to first. Marte back in standing.
When you're taking your lead over there at first, you got to be very careful. This guy on the mound's got a good pickoff move.
And now the lefty. Face hit center field. Lead runner touches second, headed for third. Throw stops the lead runner at second. Two on and two out. Thought about third, but back to second safely.
There we go.
Now here's the cleanup hitter for Arizona, Nick Castellanos. On the ground, and it finds its way through for a hit. Here comes Marte around third. Throw to third, but he's in there. And a run comes in to score.
Man, he just absolutely turned on that one, ripped it down the line. Nice job of staying in his mechanics.
So two on, but two away. Patrick Wisdom getting ready to hit.
Looking for some insurance. Or as our friends down in the South would say,
insurance.
No matter how you say it, we know what you mean.
I don't understand that one at all. Like, I just don't.
Near the bottom of the seventh. Up and in.
Beyond good and evil, another game that we're looking at playing here pretty soon. When this baseball is over. He's like nowhere near
the
strike zone.
Out of the stretch, runners at first and third.
Fuck.
Swings and misses. Good job at damage control right there.
Later.
One run in the inning, but they
don't need Titan Quest.
Now
right
into
now.
The game, Lourdes Gurriel Jr. He now takes over and right. Brandon Marsh stands in for the Phillies. Ripped to third and caught.
That swing right there tells me he's seeing the ball pretty well. I know it didn't produce a hit, but he made solid contact, and that's all you're looking to do anytime you're at the plate.
A.J. Minter comes on now,
and he's been racking up strikeouts at a high rate this year, typically at least one an inning, so he'll be tough to get to.
Base is empty, one away, and we're in the top of the eighth. Got him looking.
There's this one.
Two up, two down here at the top of the eighth. Here's Trey Turner. That clips the corner.
Well, it's critical right here that they bear down and turn in some quality at bats. Try to chip away at that lead, because if it gets to the ninth.
Two outs, base is empty. Popped up first base side. Sizing this one up. He's there. He's got it. And that'll do it. Ready for the bottom of the eighth. Here's the second baseman, Brandon Drury. Here comes a pitch. On the ground to the left. And
that's
ball.
I disagree.
Here's a 1-2. And another ball. And that one in the air center field.
On it, but just not good enough.
Makes the grab.
Not a good enough hit, man.
Here's Pete Alonso. One down, base is empty. Swing and a ball lined out towards center. Rojas snags it for the second out. Here's the center fielder, Jake McCarthy.
Not fooled at all right there. He was clearly all over it, but sometimes you hit it too hard and right at someone. You're looking for one of those blue hits to get a knock sometimes.
Two down, nobody on. puts it in the air out towards left center. Sizes this one up. Brings it in. And that is the third.
All right, I'll let Minter take the first. Take Jock.
And the pitch. Swing and a miss as he was late.
They can live up in the zone all game if hitters will chase it. That's just too much velocity. Hitters got to look down in the zone.
Cuts and misses. It's a strikeout. And digging in for Philadelphia, Alec Bohm. One down, base is empty. Swing and a foul. Pushed off to the right, and that will get out of play.
I wish you could, like, if you know it's going to be out of play, you can just skip that. Because, like, sometimes you get a, like, foul ball, and it's, like, immediately, like, foul ball. It doesn't even change from that screen. And sometimes it's like, oh, let's show it go down the line 150 feet and waste 10 seconds of your life. So, like, this one I understand. It's real close. Maybe you get there, maybe you don't. But, like, righty the delivers. One before, you know?
And there's a rocket into the outfield. Around first, heading for two. In safely. It's a double and his second hit.
That's tremendous fight from him, and I know it's got the dugout fired up down there. Down to the last strike, and he
boots it. Throw to first.
There you go, Castellanos. Gotta win the series. That's all we care about. Win the series. Take the series back tomorrow.
Team. Every ball club wants to be dominant at home. Winning a game like this just helps to boost the confidence.
Scheme's got to win good. Guys, I mean, that's a quality start, you know. Two home runs, really, just all that did it for him. Oh, so we even the series. So, yes, he's winning the series. That's all we care about. Alright, let's advance today. Alright. Alright, thanks for watching. I appreciate it. Maybe we'll get another one in this afternoon or whatever. I gotta go to work now. Very early. Alright.